because of the treachery of the other races, obviously, I'm the only one who's able to be Pharaoh. It is over. It had to be this way. The evil direction of the bloodline was the true direction chosen by God. Anything else is an accursed Nile crab at best. All right. Who anointed the next Pharaoh, right? Horus, right? It was the woman, right? Her choice anointed him. Obviously, he's chosen by God either way, but that is her role. If she does not do that, she too is accursed. So, but Isis modeled another and reconstituted the body of her husband, anointing it with precious oil. She thus performed the rites of embalmment for the first time and thereby restored Osiris to eternal life. For it was always considered in Egypt that eternal life for the soul depended on the preservation intact of the physical body. This has implications on the martial arts structure. It has to be this hawk temple, mind, body, soul, this form of martial arts in this body structure to continue the pharaonic process. She was assisted in her task by her sister Neptis, and according to some versions by Anubis, thought, Horus, and even by the four sons of Horus. Such inconsistencies were, of course, due to later accretions and the growth in importance of Osirian beliefs. So obviously, we start to see confusion, we start to see misdirection. After she had recovered her husband's body and embalmed it, Isis was seized by Set and cast into prison. Set was angry at the funerary honors done to Osiris, but did not suspect that in fact his body had been made whole and resurrected. But with the aid of Osiris's vizier, Thought, Isis managed to escape and so hide from Set the fact that she had conceived a child. Accompanied by seven protective serpents, she took refuge in the swamps of Budo and there gave birth to Horus. She rejoiced at having produced an heir for Osiris, and from then on lived for the day that when he would be old enough to avenge his father and claim his patrimony, for there was no one to dispute Set's seizure of the throne. You see how important it is for the right direction to be placed, the right person to be placed there, and that is part of the vengeance, which is characteristic, which is a key aspect of Horus and his nature, right? He is going to restore it and thus restore the right direction. There is no being Horus without restoring the true bloodline. And if that bloodline is lost, the whole world order collapses and the spiritual life of the people dies. They're empty vessels in hell. Isis had no means of support for herself and the child. Imagine the dumb fuck who judges people by their ability to support themselves and to provide. When this is a key part of even the later stories, which was meant for idiots who aren't martial artists to understand. Isis had no means of support for herself and the child, and was therefore forced to go out begging. One day, when she had been out all day, leaving the baby Horus hidden in the reeds, she came back to find him writhing about and half dead. Set, who was unable to enter the marshes in his real form, had taken the form of a poisonous snake and had crept up on Horus and bitten him. So obviously Set poisons people. Drugs, mental health, right? Psychiatry, drugging, poison him. And anyone who benefits from it is from his temple. Is guided into power by Set, not by God, not by Ra. Isis was in despair. Seemingly alone in the world, her father, her mother, and her elder brother Osiris were dead. Her younger brother Set was her implacable enemy, and her sister Neptis was his wife. Isis therefore appealed to all mankind. The marsh dwellers and fishermen immediately came to offer their help, and they wept in sympathy, but none of them knew a magical spell which would cure Horus of this poison. Isis guessed that the cause of the evil was Set. The poisoning assumed cause.